CSS today offers a lot of fantastic tools that help you style your websites easier. Nth-child is one of those tools. It's been in browsers for quite a while now, yet it's sometimes difficult to understand how exactly it works, and therefore it's often underused. In this video, I will give you an in-depth guide that will help you master it and work with it more efficiently. Let's dive in. All right, as always, I have a demo here on CodePen. Link is gonna be in the description. And here I have a list of my latest YouTube videos. Here in the code, I have this pseudo selector first child where I'm selecting the first element so you can see how it's styled. So what is nth child? Nth child is a pseudo class in CSS that lets you select a certain element among the group of siblings based on certain criteria. So let's see how it works. And the simplest way you can use it is to just write nth child with the number of the element you want to highlight. So if we write here 1, we're going to select the first element. If we write 5, we're going to select the 5th element right here, and so on. Another way you can use it is by using the keywords odd and even. And odd and even, as you expect, will select exactly odd or even list items. So let's try odd, and you see that every odd item here is selected or highlighted based on my code. And even is gonna highlight the even items, second, fourth, and so on. But where nth child shines is when you use the function notation. And function notation looks like this, a n plus b. And we will dissect this in detail right now. So first, let's see what happens if you use n. And n are actually all possible integers. So n is gonna be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on and so on. So if we switch this to n, you're gonna see that all of our elements are highlighted right here. Everything is selected. And a here stands for integer step size. And basically you can view this as a multiplier. So if we say 1n, it's gonna effectively mean 1 times n. So this is going to mean 1 times 0 is gonna be 0, 1 times 1 is gonna be 1, this element, 1 times 2 is gonna be 2, and so on and so on. Again, every element will be highlighted, but if we switch this to 2, every second element is now highlighted because we have 2 times 0 is 0, nothing is selected, 2 times 1 is 2, this element is selected, 2 times 2 is 4, and the fourth element is selected, and so on, and so on, and so on. So this is what integer step size means, or A in our notation here, and B right here stands for integer offset. So if we add plus 1 here, this is what happens in our preview, and in our code, what's happening is we have 2 times 0 is 0 plus 1 is 1, first element, 2 times 1 is 2 plus 1 is 3, third element, and so on and so on. And obviously you can tweak this integer offset as much as you like. So if we set to 5, our first element that's going to be highlighted is going to be this one because we have 2 times 0 is 0 plus 5 is 5, which is going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the first element that will be selected is element number 5 right here. And now that you understand basics of how this function notation works, you can use this to your advantage and do quite a lot with this nth child selector. So for example, if you wanted to select only the 5th element here, you could do something like 0n plus 5. Because what happens here is 0 times 0 is 0 plus 5 is 5, 0 times 1 is 0 plus 5 is 5, so only the 5th element will be selected. Obviously this particular example is not really useful as you can use just the number here, but it just gives you an idea of what you can accomplish if you just think about it in terms of function notation. So let's look at another example. If we do n plus 5, you can highlight element 5 and all the elements that come after number 5. So you have here 0 plus 5 is 5, 1 plus 5 is 6, and so on and so on and so on. Once you understand how this works, it's really easy to understand how you can utilize it. And you can actually use n as a negative value. Let's try this. Minus n plus 5 will select only our first element, because what happens here is you have minus 0 plus 5 is 5. This is gonna be 5th element, minus 1 plus 5 is 4, it's gonna be 4th element, minus 2 plus 5 is gonna be 3, so it's the 3rd element, minus 3 plus 5 is 2, it's gonna be 2nd element, and minus 4 plus 5 is 1, and this is gonna be 1st element, so only those elements are highlighted. And this way you can select first couple of elements in your list among the siblings. I'm not sure if I mentioned, but this doesn't apply only to li element. It of course applies to all elements among the group of siblings. So if you have number of diffs here and not li items, you can use this as a diff as well. So you're gonna select diff elements based on this criteria right here. Let's return this to li. For our next example, I'm gonna show you that you can actually combine nth-child pseudo classes to select a range of elements. So you can, for example, select elements from 4 to 7. So we will write n plus 4, and this will select all elements from 4 onward, because we have 0 plus 4 is 4, 1 plus 4 is 5, and so on and so on and so on. And if we add another nth-child selector here and set it to negative n plus 7, you're gonna have exactly the result we wanted. We selected elements from 4 to 7. So our first part of the selector here selects elements that are 4, 5, 6, and so on and so on. And the second part selects elements that are 7 or less. And this effectively creates a group of elements between 4 and 7 that are highlighted right here. And there's another selector that is called nth-last-child that you can also utilize. So if we say nth-last-child 4, this works exactly as nth-child, but only it counts backwards. So it counts from the last item to the first. This is 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 here is going to select our fourth number, and if we say 4n, for example, is going to select every fourth item from the last to first. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So everything that we've shown in the nth-child selector applies to nth-last-child as well, but only it counts backwards. And because nth-last-child counts backwards, there's something really cool we can do with it. And that is, we can style the entire list only if there are certain number of items in that list. Let's see how. In our list here, we have 10 elements, and maybe we want to highlight the list only if we have 10 elements or more. So we're going to write n plus 10, which is going to select the 10th element in our list, which is going to be exactly this one. And we're going to write another nth last child selector, where we're going to select the 10th element, which is again going to be the first one right here. And we're going to style all sibling li elements. And this effectively highlights all of those elements. So here, effectively, we are only selecting elements, all elements in our list, if list has at least 10 items. If I were to switch this to 11, then none of the elements will be highlighted, because what happens here is we have nth-last-child 11, which is not present on the list, doesn't exist. And we select all the sibling elements of the 11th child, doesn't exist, so nothing is selected. But if we have a lesser number, maybe 5 or 8, you're gonna see that all elements in the list are selected. To reiterate here, we're selecting the 8th element in the list right here, which is gonna be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then we're selecting all the other elements, which is gonna be 9, 10, and so on, because we have 1 plus 8 is 9, 2 plus 8 is 10, and so on and so on. So these elements here are selected with this part of the selector here. And this thing right here says we're going to select the 8th element, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And we're going to style all sibling elements that come after it. And those are going to be those li items right here. This is what the sibling selector does. So this is the trick you can use to select the entire list if a certain number of elements is present in that particular list or in that particular group of siblings. Another thing I want to show you is nth-type selector, and that works pretty similar to the nth-child selector, but what nth-type does is select elements based on the criteria we've seen, but only among the group of the elements of a certain type. So let's try this. li, nth-type of type, and we're gonna have exactly the same criteria right here. So here we have a list of li items, and this is gonna work exactly as it worked before, as we've seen in the examples with the nth child. But where this differs is if you have different elements among the siblings. Let's see our HTML here, and we're gonna add a number of paragraph items to our list. And this is not gonna be a valid HTML, but just for the sake of this demonstration, we're gonna add number of P items to our UL list. So let's change this, but this is going to be a P element. And just to see what we have here, we're gonna say paragraph, so you know exactly which elements are paragraphs. we're gonna add one here, and let's add one here, and another one maybe here. So we have three paragraphs in our li, or rather in our ul list among our li items, and you see them right here. And this is where nth of type differs from nth child. Nth child is gonna select all elements in a group of siblings. So we're gonna select all direct children of ul list, and this is gonna select every second element in our list, regardless of what type it is. But if we switch to nth of type, li nth of type, for example, you're gonna see that we're only counting li elements. So here we're selecting every other element of li type with the offset of 1. So this is gonna be element list element number 1. This is skipped. This is element number 2. This is element number 3. This is element number 4, 5. This is skipped, 6, 7. So every odd element is selected here because we have an offset of 1. And this is how nth of type works. So you can use this if you want to select only elements that are of certain type. Of course, there's also nth last of type, which works exactly the same as nth of type, but only counts from the last element to the first. So this is element number 1, 3, 5, because this one is skipped, and so on and so on. This takes exactly the same function notation as the nth child. So you can utilize nth of type if you want to select only the elements of certain type. There is another interesting thing that I want to show you, and this is actually of notation. Nth-child is supported in all browsers, including Internet Explorer, but this notation that I'm going to show you right now is currently supported only in Safari. And here I'm using Safari Technical Preview, so we write this as nth-child of something, and that something can be li in this example, in which case you wouldn't actually need this. So this example works exactly as our nth-of-type example, which only counts elements of certain type, but this differs in a way that you can actually use classes here as well. So if we were to have a class of bar, for example, and let's add this class to our HTML here, to a couple of elements, maybe this one, and this one. And right here, you're gonna see that we're selecting only the children that have a class of bar. So this one in our example. And if we were to select all the elements, you're gonna see that all our elements with the bar are selected. But if we wanna select every other one, it's gonna be the first one, it's gonna be the second one, it's gonna be the third one, it's gonna be the fourth one, and so on and so on. So basically, nth child with the of select argument notation allows you to select only elements of a certain class. Again, this is supported only in Safari at the moment, unfortunately, so it's not really ready for production. Not really sure if other browsers are planning to support this. Another interesting thing that I found is that there is actually nth-col pseudo-class with the, of course, nth-last-col class, which is gonna select the columns of a table. But unfortunately, I didn't find much documentation on it. There's just an entry on NDN. There's no info about the browser support. I've tested it out in Safari, Chrome, and Firefox. It doesn't work, so I'm not sure if that's planned to be supported or not, but really interesting thing to know that somebody has thought about using and call the select columns of a table. In any case, this is it for this video. I hope you found it helpful. I hope it gives you confidence to use nth child, well, confidently. My name is Zoran Jambor. Thank you so much for your attention. I will see and hear you in the next video.